Good morning, ma'am, or good afternoon, ma'am. I'm Reyna Ronald Jake. I'm your student nurse for today, and I will be performing or I will be doing the suctioning of newborn using a bulb syringe. For the purpose is to remove the visible mucus, secretion, and vomitus to the newborn's mouth and nares. For the assessment, assess for the following. Inspect the nose and the mouth for visible secretion and vomitus, and auscultate the newborn's lungs to evaluate the evidence of crackles and wheezes, and assess for the functioning crib and bulb syringe. And check for the air draft. And for the planning, gather and prepare the following lined hypo tray or mayo table, dry and pre-warm blanket, clean bulb syringe, mask and sterile gloves, receptacle, and do hand washing and wear gloves. For the procedure, as soon as the infant head is born, suction the mucus from the mouth to prevent the aspiration of the secretion. And compress the bulb before the insertion. Before the insertion to prevent the oral or to prevent injury to the newborn's oral mucosa, and gently insert the tip of the bulb syringe into the dependent side of the newborn's mouth to collect drainage. Then release the compression on the bulb to allow re-expansion and the collection of the secretion. Then remove the bulb syringe from the newborn's mouth and gently squeeze the bulb syringe to release the collected drainage or collected secretion into appropriate receptacle or tissue. And as soon as the infant body is born, hold the infant with the head slightly dependent and keep the infant warm by drying and providing radiant heat. Then repeat each steps to suction the other side of the newborn's mouth. If necessary, repeat each steps to suction each nares. Then discard the collected secretion properly and clean the receptacle. And wash the bulb syringe in warm soapy water, rinse and dry. Then put the bulb syringe back to the newborn's bassinet for future use. Then remove gloves. And perform hand hygiene. Then reassess the newborn's lungs, provide reassurance, comforting to the parents and newborn. Then document the procedure and other abnormal findings to the client's chart. Thank you.